Hello, everyone. Welcome again to another Word for Today with Ray. I'm always so grateful and thankful for you that you're taking the time to study the Word of God. These podcasts are designed to be 4 to 6 minutes at the most. Every now and then, one will go over that, but not much. It's enough time that you can just really a couple of red lights and you could probably listen through it. But it's to stir your mind, to encourage you to study the Word of God, to learn a principle for that day or something that can carry you through a difficult time in your life. And so we want to go to the Lord in prayer because we want Him involved in everything that we do, knowing that it's God Almighty that really has our best interests at hand. Pray with me if you will today. Heavenly Father, we bless you. We thank you for your word. We know that you're our true teacher. You promised that you'd send your Holy Spirit to guide us into all truth and that you'd empower us to live according to that truth so that we'd be your witnesses in this world. So we invite you today to be a part of our study. We're learning so much through this book of the Gospel of John and just are so grateful that you've given it to us to study today. We bless you. We thank you again for your presence. It's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. The title to today's lesson is The Men Sitting Down. The Apostle John wrote how Jesus went over the Sea of Galilee, which is the Sea of Tiberias, and a great multitude followed him because they saw his miracles, which he did on them that were diseased. And Jesus went up into a mountain, and there he sat with his disciples. And the Passover, a feast of the Jews, was near. When Jesus then lifted up his eyes and saw a great company coming to him, he said unto Philip, "Where shall we buy bread that these may eat?" And this he said to prove him, for he himself knew what he would do. Philip answered him, 200 penny worth of bread is not sufficient for them, that every one of them may take a little. One of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said unto him, "There is a lad here which has 5 barley loaves and 2 small fishes, but what are they among so many?" And in chapter 6 and verse 10 of his book, John shared how Jesus said, "Make the men sit down, in number about 5,000, where we read, "And Jesus said, "Make the men sit down." Now there was much grass in the place, so the men sat down, in number about 5,000. The verse reads, "And Jesus said, "Make the men sit down." Now there was much grass in the place. Jesus began with the words, "And Jesus said," or, "And the Son of God, the Savior of mankind, and God incarnate, uttered, declared, proclaimed, and instructed, make the men sit down," which means cause and appoint the men to be seated. Now there was much grass, or moreover, there existed a large amount of herbage, hay, or grass in the place, which means in the location where Jesus ministered on the mountainside. John shared how Jesus instructed his disciples to have the men to be seated upon the grass which overlay the mountainside. The verse goes on to say, "So the men sat down, in number about 5,000. John continued with the words, "So the men sat down," which means, therefore the men were seated, in number about 5,000, or, "And the number of them was around 5,000 men. John shared how Jesus' disciples obeyed him and directed the 5,000 men to be seated. When we consider the words in this verse, we learn how Jesus began to organize the crowd of people for what he was about to do next. God is a God of order. And for the men to be easily accessed for this miracle, Jesus had his disciples seat them. God has a plan for each and every person. And when they yield their life to his Son Jesus as their Savior and Lord, he carefully begins to fulfill his purposes in their lives. Those who are wise will seek the Lord Jesus to see if there are specific organizational efforts he is making in their lives as they submit to his every instruction. Next time, John shares how Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed to the disciples. So read ahead, and we shall join together then. Until tomorrow, there is more. And may the Lord bless you and keep you. May he make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace as you continue to study his word in Jesus' name.